Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin. In this 3ds Max tips video, we're going to cover several methods to save hard disk space when working with 3ds Max. We're going to cover three things: file compression, instantiation, and proxy. Okay, first about file compression. It is hard to believe that a lot of 3ds Max users don't know that there is a file compression feature built into 3ds Max, and that feature is turned off by default. To turn that thing on, you need to go to Customize menu, then Preference, then click in this Files tab. Down here, you will find Compress on Save option. Click the checkbox to turn it on. Now, when you save file, it looks like 3ds Max saving it as ordinary .max file just like before. But if you look closely, the file size of it will be significantly smaller than before. For example, I have this scene from one of my projects. When I save it without compression, it takes about 17 MB. But with Compress on Save option turned on, 3ds Max able to save the file to only about 6 MB file size. That is almost one third of the original file size. For one file, you may not get significant benefit, but just imagine if you have hundreds of Max files taking up to 3 TB disk space before. Now you can save it in only 1 TB space, that is 2 TB of disk space saving. That's a huge difference. The nice thing about this method is that you don't need to use or install other file compression software, and your 3ds Max file is still in .max format and not in other format. Next is instantiation. When you have identical objects scattered around your scene, it is best to use instant instead of copy. By using instant, you basically tell 3ds Max to save the object's geometry once in the memory, but display it several times. Besides impact to RAM usage and rendering time, the impact to file size is also big. Let's take a look at this example. In this scene, I have these 1000 teapots. They are all editable poly objects, and they are all independent objects, meaning they are not instances. When I save the file, I have this 83 MB file size. Now, we have the same scene setup with 1000 teapot editable objects, but right now, all of them are instances to each other. Notice, if I grab one of them, go to Vertex Sub-Object mode and just tweak them a bit, we can see not only the teapot that we have is changing, but also all of the teapot in the scene. When I save the file, it only takes around 2 MB. Huge difference if you are working with exceedingly numerous objects in your scene. This is because, again, as I explained before, instances will enable 3ds Max to save the geometry information only once, although displaying it multiple times. Okay, so now how can we create instances? We create them when cloning objects. Let's say we want to have a lot of trees from this one tree object. Simply click to select it and hold Shift, then move it to this position. Now look at this option. We have copy, instance, and reference. If the tree's geometry will be identical from one to another, we always want to go for instance, not copy. Later, we can scale each instances independently, or rotate it, or move it with no problem. Each instance has their own unique transformation, so we can use this as our advantages. We can move it and rotate them a bit and give different scale values, so we have more variation and the scene looks more natural. There are scripts and plugins that can do this for us, but that will be for another tutorial, inshallah. Okay, our next discussion is about proxy. Let's define what is proxy first. In terms of 3D animation, proxy is a dummy object in our scene used to represent the real 3D model from external sources. We use proxy usually together with instancing. So we use it for the things that are repeatable in our scene, and we use them again and again for different projects. In architectural visualization projects, for example, we use proxies for 3D trees, 3D people or crowd, cars, etc. Usually, we set proxies to show up in a viewports as low-resolution objects such as box or point clouds, but when you hit the render button, they will show up as the original high-resolution objects. So, proxy is used mainly for saving RAM usage, but it works very well also for saving hard disk space. To make things more clear, let's say we have a 3ds Max file, inside it a scene with a lot of 3D objects needed for a finished project. Now the total of the 3ds Max file size is 100 MB. The number is just for example only. With proxy, we can take out the tree type number 1 geometry, put it in the library folder and replace the object in the scene with a proxy object. Then we do the same with tree type number 2, and so on and so forth. And then we take out the cars and people models and replace them with proxy again. Okay, now this setup will have big advantages. First, the 3ds Max file size reduced significantly. And then if later we save the file to version 2, then 3, and so on, the benefit effect will be multiplied and more hard disk space are being saved because we don't need additional disk space for saving these objects again. And then, if we have a new project that uses the same library object of trees, cars, and 3D people as before, we simply create proxies from these external library files. So as you can see, utilizing proxies in your projects can give you a ton of benefits, and one of them is saving your system's disk space. Okay, the next question is, how can we create proxy? Mostly, proxy are technology provided by rendering engines. So if you are working with Mental Ray, you can create Mental Ray proxy. If you use V-Ray, you can create V-Ray proxy. And if you are like me who choose Corona Renderer, you can create Corona proxy. I believe every rendering engines have their own way of creating proxy. I'm not going into the technical details about how to create this proxy, just enough for us to see the big picture and understand why proxies are an important part of CG workflow nowadays. Okay guys, that's it for this 3ds Max Tips video. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos like this. If you want to learn 3ds Max from scratch, no prior experience needed, and be able to create this interior scene, be sure to check out my Udemy course 3D Visualization for Beginners. I have 90% discount available until end of March 2016, only for those who watch this video. That is all. I hope this video helped you somehow. Wassalamualaikum.